नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। आई एम जेवीएन डॉक्टर अनामिका अहरवार, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी एट ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक द लेक्चर ऑन द टॉपिक मॉडिफिकेशंस टू बेसिक मॉडल। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू अबाउट द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बिहेवियर। This organization behavior is very important for the organization, because as per the behavior of the things, the management or the organization can take the decisions. So though an organization of course is structured according to the goals and objectives to be achieved, the actual performance is at variance for various reasons. So you can say there are some factors beyond the control of the management which affect the performance of the organization. So however, there are some factors which relate to the organization, and the performance is basically affected due to the organization behavior. And the behavior of organization is a result of the following factors. And what are these factors? These are the organization culture, organizational power, organizational change, organizational learning, organizational motivation. Now let's discuss one by one. First is the organizational culture. Culture is very much important for the society, for the professional area where we are working. So for in the organization, you can say in the institute or your workplace, you can say in simply. So the culture is a set of attitudes, beliefs, values, norms and understandings the people have in the organization. The culture is a collective behavior results of the people who man the organization. So this is basically depending upon the person, whether he is a manager, an officer, of a worker, the cultural pattern emerges, and it is known as a managerial culture and a work culture, etc. So for this, long-term performance and managerial actions depend on the managerial culture, and the achievement of the targets depend on the work culture. The culture may be reflected in the philosophy, policy, strategy, goals and managerial styles of the organization. If the organization culture is generated a behavior which acts the performance adversely, it can be changed by management actions such as training, education, creating awareness and so on. Okay. Now come to the organizational power. In this, the organization power is the ability of the organization structure to use human and material resources to achieve the stated goals and objectives of the organization. So the power of the organization is not disturbed uniformly all over the organization, but you can say it may be concentrated in small groups representing a function, a department or a section. It might be localized with the individuals. So there are some individuals, by virtue of their position, responsibility and seniority, so enjoy more power than others. Some individuals, by virtue of their nearness to the management and a strong personality, derive power in the organizational structure. This is the organizational power. Then next is the organizational change. Of course, this is also important factor. Even though the organization is structured properly, over the period of time it starts falling slowly due to the changes in the environment, the people and the business. So it all depends on the outcome of the scenario. So like a living organism, an organization undergoes a process of birth and death. So the process of organization outlives the purpose for which it is established, moves much faster if proper corrective action is not taken. So the organization structure is in its life cycle, starting from the introduction, growth, maturity and decline, should change suitably in the respective phases. The behavioral change through the organization change is achieved by creating a climate for change, designing and implementing the change, watching and institutionalizing the change. Next come to the organizational learning. This organization behavior improves with the experience it gathers from all the business fronts. So with the experienced people are in position to identify the cause and effect relationship. So this is very important. So the individuals of the organization are able to access the strength and weakness within them and are able to take steps to improve. So this is very much a good actually if you see it from positive perspective. So as organizational learning increases, the organization's behavior shows maturity. So with increased learning, the organization moves towards high degree of formulation affecting the scores, beliefs and the organization learning is faster, of course, if people and the management are dynamic and progressive. Now in the organization learning, organization motivation, the organization of a system means there are two leadership styles, which is you can say autocratic and supportive. In an autocratic of course style, the leader determines for business style leader determines everything and dictate decisions. So the decisions are enforced by this power of the authority. The next is the organization of a system means a system is an assembly of elements arranged in a logical order to achieve certain objectives. The organization is also arranged it is a type of assembly of elements arranged in a local order to active certain objectives. The organization is also a system of people, the individuals in the organization are selected in terms of numbers, quality and ability, and are placed in hierarchical order to plan and execute the business activities to achieve certain goals and objectives. So you can say it is the simplest justification for calling the organization a system. Now this come to the organization learning. In this of course, if we are talking about the learning, there is an arrangement of tasks in the terms of process and work design is dependent on the people, the choice of technology of handling, and you can say the task dependent on the people. Second thing is the you may choose the best technology and well designed task, but they have to be suited, not the people. So further fourth element has been added in culture. According to Leviton organization, should be viewed as a socio-technical system consisting of people, task, technology, culture and structure. Thank you. This is all about today's session. This session powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. Hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in the comment box. I will resolve it.